Hey, cycling community, this is Steve Grusis, the Cycling Greek. I'm the type of guy that needs a goal to work toward. Now that the district road races are over with, I find it pretty hard to amble through life without one. Now, I do have a moderately long-term goal, which is nationals next year. Everyone knows that if you're in masters and you reach another five-year age grouping, you're going to nationals. But just going to nationals is not good enough for me. I'm looking to get on the podium. That goal is pretty far away, so I was looking for some intermediary goals that'll complement that long-term goal. I find myself in a different position at this time of the year than I have in the previous 2 years. I have not gotten AFib after my district championship road race. I still have some racing I can do. So, I mapped out some crits and road races I can do in the next 6 weeks before the season ends. During the off-season, there's a couple of local uphill individual time trials and an uphill two-man team time trial. Let's talk about that two-man team time trial. It all started from this ride that you're seeing on the screen right now. My teammate William asked me to help him break 1 hour on this 12-mile climb. And this climb has a little bit of everything in it. There's a lot of steep in it, but there's some false flats, there's a little bit of descending, and there's some walls. I looked back at my Strava account and saw that my fastest time was a little over 1 hour and 3 minutes. But that's when I was younger, so I wasn't holding out a lot of hope that we can actually break 1 hour, but I wanted to give it the old college try. On the average throughout the year, William and I are pretty evenly matched. Sometimes I'm a little stronger than he is at certain things at certain parts of the year, and vice versa. On this day, I was a little stronger in climbing, and he was a little stronger on the flats, so we complemented each other quite well. I gotta say, I'm glad I was a little stronger on those climbs, because if I wasn't, I really would have been hurting trying to keep up with him. As it turned out, I did my customary die near the end. I fell off the pace on the last little wall right before the finish. William came in 14 seconds ahead of me at 1 hour, 7 minutes, 1 second. We averaged 10.7 miles per hour. We need to get to 12 miles per hour. That's going to be a huge jump. Nonetheless, we're going to give it the old college try. So what do you do when your goal comes and goes? Do you already have another goal in mind and you start working on the details? Or you do not think about it at all, take a little break, and then just deal with it later? Comment below. And when you do that, remember to like and subscribe. The Cycling Greek.